Hello everyone, myself Reshma Nauli. I am a student of the MSc Part 2. My roll number is 10024 and my presentation topic name is GCMS. GCMS means gas chromatography mass spectrometry. First of all, let us know what is a chromatography. So, chromatography is a laboratory technique for separation of a mixture. Now, what is a GCMS? GCMS is a hyphenated technique. Hyphenated means combination between spectroscopic technique and chromatographic technique. In GCMS, GC is the chromatographic technique and MS is the spectroscopic technique. Introduction. Gas chromatography mass spectrometry is an analytical method that combines the feature of gas chromatography and mass spectrometry to identify different substances within a test sample. Gas chromatography is a technique capable of separating, detecting, and partially characterizing the organic compounds, particularly when present in a small quantity. Mass spectroscopy provides some definite structural information from in small quantity. The separation and identification of the component of a complex natural and synthetic mixture are achieved more quickly than any other technique with a less sample. It is one of the most accurate and efficient tools for analyzing volatile organic samples. Let us move on the next slide. This is a layout of the GCMS and what exactly GC instrument do and mass spectrometer do. So, gas chromatography is separated the mixture of the chemical so each can be identified individually. And mass spectrometer is identify or detect chemical based on their molecular weight or masses. Now GCMS, it is a chemical analysis technique combining two instruments, provide for a powerful separation and identification capabilities. Now what are the historical background of GCMS? Roland Goyke and Fred McLaughlin introduced use of MS as a detector of GC in 1950s. Miniaturized computer has helped in the simplification of the instrument. In 1968, the Finjan Instrument Corporation deliver the first quadruple GCMS. By the 2000s, computerized GCMS instrument using quadruple technology had become both essential to a chemical research and one of the most instrument used for organic analysis. In 2005, GC MSMS have been introduced. Now, what are the basic principle of the GCMS? So, the GC works on the principle that mixture will separate into individual substances when they heat. The heated gas are carried through a column with an inert gas such as the helium. As the separated substances emerge from the column opening, they flow into the MS. Then mass spectrometry identifies compound by the mass of the analyte molecules. Instrumentation of GCMS. This is a layout of the GCMS. So, GC, atmospheric density heated at 200 to 300 degrees Celsius. Both systems are heated at 200 to 300 degrees Celsius. Both deal with the compound in the vapor state. Now, interface. Interface means a connection between the two things, that is GC and MS. So, the interface play important role in a GCMS, that is the pressure incompatibility problem between GC and MS was solved by inserting an interface that means operation of the MS occurs vacuum, that is a 10⁻⁶ torque, whereas GC occurs high pressure. Then what happens if lot of pressure goes on the vacuum? It gets damaged. So in that, to protect this type of damage, we require interface. Now GC chromatography, gas chromatography contains carrier gas, pneumatic control, injector, column, oven. Interface, there are different types of interface: jet interface, direct capillary infusion interface, Washington-Beeman effusion separator, मास स्पेक्ट्रोमीटर कंसिस्ट आयन सोर्स हाई वैक्यूम सिस्टम मास एनालाइजर आयन कलेक्टर एंड देन डाटा सिस्टम. दिस इज अ डायग्राम ऑफ द GCMS. इन दिस डायग्राम सो यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम ऑन द राइट हैंड राइट साइड इज द जी सी एंड फॉर एंड लेफ्ट साइड इज MS एंड दैट ट्रांसफर लाइन इज नथिंग बट इंटरफेस. Then how GCMS work? First sample is injected into the GC port, which is heated to up to 200 to 300 degrees Celsius, where the material is volatilized and then separated into its various component using the capillary column. As the component of the mixture are separated and elute from the column at a different time, once components leave the GC column, they transfer to the MS using interface. So what is the exact role of the interface? The interface is one which reduces the pressure from high pressure end to low pressure vacuum region. And whatever the gas that is the mobile phase passing, we don't require that much gas. So 99% gas went towards the end and the only 1% gas along with the component which passes to the MS, where component are ionized and fragmented by using MS using electron or chemical ionization sources, and they separated on their different mass to charge ratio and gets reaches to the detector. Then on the recorder we obtain a signal. This is the working process of the GCMS. Now application of GCMS. In a different field, GCMS are used. First, environmental monitoring and cleanup. Second, criminal forensic. GCMS used in a law enforcement, sport anti-doping analysis, in security, in chemical warfare agent detection, in food, beverage and perfume analysis, in astrochemistry, in medicine. There are some advantages and disadvantages of the GCMS. So advantages is high sensitivity, that is excellent detection limit, typically low ppb to high ppb. High selectivity, that is identification is based on the two parameters, not one. That is a retention time and mass spectrum must match standard. Select analyte of interest with very high confidence. Now speed. Typical analysis takes from half hour to approx 1 hour. Analysis can contain upwards of the 18 and more pollutants. Now disadvantages. Higher capital cost, higher maintenance. For optimum result requires analysts knowledgeable in both chromatography and mass spectrometry. Thank you.